Hello students, welcome to Kingdom of Learning, the educational channel. Today I am going to explain the novel The Invisible Man. Since it is a very long novel and it has 28 chapters, so all the chapters will be explained in different videos. So you can watch all the videos to understand the novel completely. So before we start, let us know about the author, the novelist. H.G. Wells, his full name is Herbert George Wells, and he was born on 21st September 1866 in England. He is famous for his science fiction genre. This novel, The Invisible Man, was first published in 1952, and immediately after its publication, it became a masterpiece. Means this novel was liked so much by all the people because of its theme of suspense and the darkness that is related to it. So now in this video, we will discuss the summary of chapter 1 of the novel. So let us see. When the story starts, there is shown a stranger who arrives at the inn, coach and horses. And a snowstorm is going on, means the weather is very cold, and coach and horses is the name of the inn in which a stranger whose name is actually Griffin, he arrives there, and that inn, coach and horses, is in Epping. Epping is a real town in England, and if you know, H.G. Wells is famous for using real places in his stories. So here in this story also, he has used a real location, Epping, that is in England. So now we see that the stranger who has arrived in Epping, he is totally covered. Means his whole body is covered and only his shiny nose is visible. He is wearing spectacles with side lights, which basically look like goggles. Means he is wearing some spectacles, and on those spectacles some side lights are there, and at least one person says he looks like he is wearing a diving helmet, the old fashioned kind, of course. Means the way he is wearing those spectacles, it seems as if he is wearing a helmet that is used for swimming. Now the stranger no doubt looks very strange, very weird. But he has money, means he is a rich person. So that is the reason that the innkeeper, she is a lady. Her name is Mrs. Hall. And although that was a weather when not many tourists came to that place, but when she finds one customer, she immediately gives him shelter. Means she immediately gives him one room to stay in her inn, coach and horses. So no doubt, Mrs. Hall is surprised by the appearance of that stranger when she sees him in his room when he is without his hat. Means as long as he was covered with his hat, it was okay. But when Mrs. Hall looks in the room of the stranger and he has removed his hat, at that time she finds him to be very strange. She finds that his forehead above his blue glasses was covered by a white bandage, and another was covered with ears. Means another bandage covered his ears, and not only a single part of his face was visible, and only his pink and peaked nose was visible. Means whole of his face was covered with bandages. So the thick black hair escaping as it could below and between the cross bandages projected in curious tails and horns, and means it appeared as if he had some very strange kind of tails and horns on his head, because everything was covered properly. So that's why his appearance was looking very strange. So Mrs. Hall was really shocked and surprised to look at that stranger. But luckily, he has covered the lower part of his face with the napkin, so she doesn't have to deal with that, what is there. So Mrs. Hall assumes, she thinks that perhaps this man might have met with an accident. That is why he is wearing so many bandages on his face. So she tries to talk to him about what has happened, but that man was not at all interested in talking to that lady. So he does not show any interest in that lady, whatever she asks him. So instead, he only tells one thing to her. He says that she should get his luggage from the railroad station. So he only wants this thing, that his luggage should be shifted from the station to this inn. And not quite as good for gossip. So Mrs. Hall is disappointed that this man is not going to listen to her and is not going to share anything with her. So in this way, first chapter comes to an end. So thank you very much. If you find it useful, share it with others. Subscribe the channel Kingdom of Learning. And if you want to read motivational and inspirational blogs, you can open the link of my website stiryoursoul.in that is provided in the description box. Thank you very much.